I see you, dear viewer, and welcome back to another Red Flood video. Today we should be playing as the Great Scythia, the Krug Gathering. We are a puppet of Mr. Kolchak and his sticky sausage fingers, so we shall break away upon a certain event occurring between these certain quote-unquote nations. Russia's little slice of limbo. It is currently the year of our Lord 1936, although the saints have seen fit to preserve Holy Russia for the time being, as politics are frayed to a near breaking point. The Southeastern Union is no different. Governed by Don Cossack Cavalry General Alexei Kaledin, the Southeastern Union is one of the few places in the Russian Empire which is governed by a leader from the local ethnic group. Still, however, many Cossacks yearn for an end to Russian rule, and the significant Ukrainian minority in the region is also making itself known. There are even whispers of men both within and without the government who seek to restore the ancient Scythian Empire. That's us. And while this is obviously ridiculous, the rumors are far too prevalent to be ignored. Such disunited politics, as well as a general disagreement over an ethnic identity for the Southeastern Union, have earned this warlord state the title Russia's little slice of limbo, as the area seems in constant danger of becoming something brand new at any moment and can't stick to one identity. Even as Kaledin continues to rule with an iron fist, he knows that his time is running short. The time is running short for him, and his band of merry men. All that it would take for the entire region to go up in flames and in one false move or freak accident, which could send the entire empire into collapse. And although Kaledin knows these things, he's determined to protect his realm and his people, just as he always has, down to the last breath. What the general may not know is that his last breath may come sooner than he expects. The currency issue. These terrible mitts do look rather shiny. Issue of the military. Modernization is decided. The education issue. Russian schools are made by Russians and they should be for Russians. The issue of internal autonomy. Abolish all the autonomies. And the issue of political refugees. The Russian dissidents shall be our priority. The Krug sessions. Vote counting begins. The session of the Krug is ended, with every representing having cast their votes. As the votes are cast, the feeling of tension between ethnicities and political groups becomes even more palpable. It seems as though no matter what the result is, a period of unprecedented political violence is on the horizon. In an effort to somewhat avoid this, the previously divided factions of the Krug have declared an agreement to form a coalition government if there is no clear majority. However, it is unlikely that these makeshift alliances will last very long, especially if the ever-ambitious Scythists are brought into power. Regardless, the Southeastern Union must respect the results of the election, whatever they may be. The Southeastern Union waits with bated breath. Dominant faction emerges as the Southeastern Union's Krug continued to bicker for days over issues. It seemed that ever more transformations were occurring within the Krug over the course of several debates. Polarization is at an all-time high, and it appears that one faction has emerged dominant over the others. As more members shift their allegiances towards the latest decisions made by the Krug, however, it might be decided that a coalition is best, resulting in an unprecedented amount of organization and solidarity amongst the inner party members. And so it is decided that through one final vote over a minor issue, it will be realized which faction is dominant. If the two factions are as dominant as each other, they will be forced to make a coalition against the other, and like so, the fate of the Southeastern Union hangs in the balance. The Scythists dominate the Krug alone. And Gorgulov on the stage. Hello, Mr. Gorgulov. National Peasant Program. National Peasant Program. No capitalists. No minorities. No Jews. Okay, man. 157 Jews live within the entirety of the Caucasus. No monarchists. No monarchists. And no communists. The birth of Great Scythia. Oh, there we go. There goes the war thing. Summer coup war. Loyal as ever to Russia. We are now independence, finally! Supremacy of the Scythian race, some of that industry crushed the degeneracy and the supremacy of the Peasants' Party. The rise of the new barbarians. Violet will overthrow the machine. Yes, we're Scythians! Yes, we're Asians! I swear! Sacramenia, attack! the Caucasian Federation of Soviets, aka Mr. Kavkaz Society, aka Mr. Joseph Stalin, aka the shithead accelerationist, aka go fuck yourself. Kavkaz is about to invade Armenia, so I need to hurry the fuck up. Never mind, it's gonna be too fucking late, because it always is. Hooray! Goodbye, Armenia. I'm sorry for not being able to save you. Skrra. And he declared on me. Okay. Hakapele, paganism. Ah, nice. Now they're encircled. Yes, thank you, bro. Encircle division. Skill them all. Execute. Mr. What's his name? Mayakovsky. Bro, I gotta hurry this shit up, man, so that Rasputin doesn't come in and kill me. Batum. Take Batum. Matumba. Yes! Fuck you, Kavkaz! Bashkir should not exist. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Here we go. A new army under Mr. Drippy Mustache. He looks like the Lorax. Yeah, he kind of looks like the Lorax, though. Kill Rasputin. Dumb fuck. Kumiev. One division encircled. You should pin there to take Samara. Strafpol and continue up to Kazan. That annihilate the Siberians. Three divisions encircled makes my day so much easier and so much happier. Damn fucking. What's his name? Rasputin was supposed to die 10, 20 years ago. Something like that. Haha, there we go. Okay, Mr. Vlasov, you dumb bastard, you're next. There we go. Grand battle plan against all of them. Burn Kolchak's nest, even though Kolchak isn't in power, it's Mr. John Sodsky. Put him on, like, war crimes or something. I'm sure that happens a lot here in Russia. Lorax General. Oh, he's pretty close. So, if I take the cap, we'll probably end up capitulating. There we go. There we go! There goes Mr. Vlasov. Now then, we shall continue with Mr. Baron Ungern von Sternberg. The Mad Mahakala. Trans-Siberia. AKA Mongolia. Oh, it's just like the Korean War, but more in the Korean Republic's favor. No Juche today. 2-1, and go! Yes, sir. Come on, take the Wolfsask. There we go. Fuck you, man. That is retarded. Never mind. Here we go. That massive battle plan. Take ooh la la, mia, me, mamma mia. So français. France, oui, oui. Croissant. Even though croissant is fucking Austrian. Sablin, Mikhail Sablin, is that? Not too sure if that's Mr. Wholesome, though, from TNO. Irkutsk, Belotsarsk. My city, my rightful land. Because I took it, I took Belotsarsk from the band Baron.
Then fucking Mr. Miliukov said, no, actually, I think that's my land.
Hold on. Attack. Come on. Yes, we've taken Irkutsk, and they are halfway to dying. Yes, there we go. Moron. I'm gonna take Moron. It's not because I am one, but, yeah. Belotsarsk. It's mine, as it always should have been. There we go. Aha, the entirety of Siberia has been reunited. Now for Mr. Landrei in Moskva, Nasha. Attack of the Russian Empire. 14 days. And 3, 2, 1, and go. Here we go. Cross out of Crimea. Start out with a big attack. Nice. Just like that. Take Ukraine. Ukrainsky. Polskaya, Polotova. Belgorod, these nuts.
Oh my god.
I'm going to kill every single Russian, even though I am one. No, We're not Russian, we're Scythian, yeah. Okay, at least we took Perm, but Jesus Christ, I think they're pushing me. Bro, fucking Mon... Dude, Tanitsuva started out with better infrastructure than me. French Terminator assassin guy. Guy who killed a French president or whatever. Will reunite Russia and kill more French people. No more capitalists, no more communists, no more fucking monarchists. Only Scythia, only the ancient great empire of Scythia. Scythmarchia. Maybe we could even snake the Moscow, actually. That'd be pretty awesome. By the way, they're fucked, so... wouldn't really matter, just for my own satisfaction. Ah, no! Resistance! Come on, Moskva! 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 Shit! Scheisse! Just keep on going, keep on going, keep on going. And... there we go. There we go. Great Scythia arises. Enter it. Great Scythia arises. Scythiasts unify Russia. A great shadow has fallen over Russia. The savage bands of Pavel Gorgulov have conquered the old Tsarist lands and have established a new barbaric order. Tales of bloody purges and pogroms have greatly concerned international observers as Russia is reshaped into a new Scythia. Masses of peasants, scythes in hand, or Scythia, I don't know. Scythes in hand are marshaled to punish the communist bourgeoisie and minorities of the country. They hold responsible for the past decades of devastation. Orthodoxy has been transformed into a religion of blood and nature, of steppe, brutality, and austerity. Through struggle and shed blood, Russian supremacy has been forged in steel. It is unknown what the next ambition of the Green Vosge will be, but it is assumed that he does not mean for the transformation of Russia to be his last word. Soon, perhaps, the Scythian hordes will march west to demonstrate the power of the Russian nation to Europe. Violet will overthrow the machine. Russian unification. Russia is like a sphinx, rejoicing, grieving, and drenched in black blood. It gazes at you with hatred and with love. Alexander Block, like an old barrel. Now we are great Scythia.
Hurrah!
We will conquer Eurasia. Here we go. We will conquer Eurasia. Great Scythia is declared on the Intermarium, the Second War of the Winter Lead. Zemstano Roga. Some of Ukraine and Sallies are preparing for a war against us, citing their territorial claims on the left bank of the Dnieper. The Intermarium is preparing to strike against us, given our weakened position due to our recent reunification of our motherland. To victory. We shall go. Except I was the one who fucking striked first, man. Stop lying. Don't let him reinforce this, though, man. As you can see, I'm struggling so fucking much to cross in order to invade Ukraine. Don't demonetize me for that one, YouTube, please. Thank you. There we go. Ooh. One division. Mama fucking amia. Haha. Alright. Continue all the way to Mukolive, yeah. Alright, to encircle this small portion of the visions. Yes. There. And? There we go. Haha. Accelerationists are currently on crack. And again, they're accelerationists, so what do you expect? This already happened. But okay. Zemsta, whatever the fuck, again. Bilatserfa. Sorry, Ukraine, but you're not gonna hold on this time around. Here we go, there we go. Now they are all encircled. There we go. Yes! Nice. Oh shit, we're breaking through. Didn't even realize. Go to Minsk. Belarus is now Rus. Oh. Oh. A double whammy. Very nice. Belarus. The entirety of what remains is now encircled and is ready to die to Mr. Gorgulov's hands. Here goes Belarus. Oh, how? Krakow, okay. Krakow and Katowice are now open for my taking. Yeah, they all have military access to fucking Hungary. God damn it. There we go. Doesn't really matter. Poland's still dead. And we are massive now. Ha. And go beyond. Green moon rising. Children across the Yekaterinodarsk Scythian Elementary School huddled around the in a bulletin board near the entrance of the school in big, bold Cyrillic writ out, "From the steppes to the moon. Our great Vaz Gorgulov has decided to bring the spirit of the steppe and its nomads to a new level, investing millions of chervonets into a new space program. As we reach for the stars with the soul of a horse beneath our feet, it is entirely encouraged to tell others about it, and perhaps in any travels you do, tell everyone you can about it. These news will show the world of the advancements in science and spiritual knowledge that our great Scythia has harnessed by 1950. Soon the movement will be green. Propaganda ministry of Ekaterinodar." The children looked excitedly and clamored at the thought. The moon? How would one ever reach something so far away? If they weren't under Gorgulov's leadership with its Scythian spirit of nomadism and constant dynamicism, energy and prowess, this will surely be a force that no other country could reckon with. With people hearing about it even far away from Yekaterinodar, even some American reporters were bewildered. The Scythians, when considered a joke by many moderate-minded Americans, now stand in shock as they realize it is a true force to be reckoned with. It seems that, by the power of initiative, Gorgulov's great Scythia will likely be the first to reach the moon. Perhaps we are madmen no longer. However, the fun does not end here. But we can invade Anatolia, Balkans, Central Europe, the Idolizers, aka Germany, puppet Sweden, and Japan, which we shall do. Yeah.